All right, so we're going to do a less than 5 minute installation of SKSE. You'll go to skse.silverlock.org and download the version of SKSE that you want to use. I've been using the beta build, which seems to be working perfectly fine. You'll go ahead and download the 7-zip archive, which I have already done, and extract it to your desktop. This is the folder that you will end up with once you've extracted the file. Open it up. There's a number of files inside. We're going to go ahead and go into our Skyrim directory, which is going to be in C, Program Files, Steam, Cmaps, Common, and Skyrim. I have a shortcut for that on my desktop. Every file in the SKSE folder that starts with SKSE can be copied. Control C. Now we'll click over here and Control V. I already have the files in there. You probably will not get this if you are installing SKSE for the first time. I'm just going to copy and replace. Now all of the binaries are properly installed. We're going to go over here to data. We're going to send to compressed zipped folder. Now open up Mod Organizer or Nexus Mod Manager, and you will install this the way you would a third-party mod. Just select the archive, click open, rename it to something you can remember. I've just called mine SKSE, locate it, and turn it on. SKSE is now properly installed for Skyrim and should work perfectly fine. If you are using Mod Organizer, you're probably going to want to put a shortcut for the SKSE loader onto your desktop. Open up the Skyrim folder, find SKSE, the skseloader.exe, right click, send to desktop. And now you will launch Skyrim through this instead of the launcher, or the regular Skyrim launcher in Steam. And for Mod Organizer, it should automatically detect SKSE once it's installed, and you will select it from the drop-down menu here and click Run. And that is all you need to know.